Do you want to talk?
That's two on him now. The motherfucker's got Clementine has Ben and Kenny to answer for.
Keep a clear head, Lee.
We wouldn't be out here. We'd all been together to defend against Vernon. And we'd be out on the water. Everyone would be alive.
Look, Lee, this is a shitty time, but I want to clear something up.
What is it?
Now with Kenny gone, means Omid and I have to stay safe. For her.
You guys would be great for her. Keep her safe.
We do our best. You know that.
Good. Thanks. Whatever your best is, I'll trust it.
That's all you can do. Fuck. Be careful across here.
River Street's just up ahead. Whoa, careful.
Even the buildings are full.
I don't know where the next meal is.
No, they don't.
I didn't mean...
It's fine. Let's go. Marsh House Hotel is around the corner of the block. We have to cross here.
Well, at least it doesn't look like a death trap. Who's going first?
You're the lightest.
He's got a busted leg, and you're walking for two. I'm obviously not doing so hot. Decision doesn't make itself. I'll go first, in case anything happens out there.
You sure?
Yeah.
Just go nice and slow.
Almost there. It's an easy crossing.
Good. Shit!
Oh, fuck! Shit!
Are you okay?
Fine. I'm kind of fucked here.
What are you gonna do?
I'll figure something out.
There's not a ton of options.
Can you help me?
I don't know what we can do from here.
Anything!
It's fucked, Lee!
Fuck it. I'm going for it!
Going for it?
What does that mean?
It means I'm already bitten. I just have to push my way through.
What the fuck? But maybe you got to it fast enough. Maybe you'll be fine.
I can't risk losing more time on a long shot. Let's meet outside of town, by the train!
Are you nuts?!
It's the only way! Do you hear me?!
Yeah, by the train!
Jesus! We'll be there!
I got us adjoining rooms.
Where is she?
I already told you she's fine. You look horrible. And you're missing an arm. Go over there. Put your things down.
Let me out! Who's out there?
Quiet, please, sweetie. Your things. There.
Just be cool.
Do I not seem cool? Good. Go sit down. Do you know who I am?
No. I don't know anything about you.
You wouldn't. People like you don't. Now you're thinking, who would have it out for me, huh? A few weeks back, there might have been a station wagon in the forest, full of all sorts of food, water, things you need to survive. Yeah, I'm not some cannibal, Lee. Some killer out in the woods. Some villain. I'm just a dad. I coach Little League.
Everything was just out there for the taking. We were starving.
For the taking? Do you know what you took from me?
I'm sorry. Whatever it is, whatever happened, you have to hear that I'm sorry.
That doesn't mean anything to me. I wish it did. I'm not a bad man. I don't believe in vengeance. But I've got nothing left. Have you ever hurt somebody you care about?
Not on purpose.
If it were on purpose, you'd be a sociopath. I hurt her so bad. My son Adam went missing. I took him out hunting even though my wife said he was too young. I figured he had to learn. I came back without him and the look on her face said, "You are a monster." We all went out looking for him. We never found him. I hurt her so bad. Then you took all of our things. You robbed us. I could have earned her trust back, Lee, but not after that.
I'm sorry.
The hungrier we got, the more she blamed me. Until she finally took our daughter Elizabeth and left. They didn't get far. I found them a day later in the road. Do I look like a monster to you?
No.
I'm not like you. You killed a man with a pitchfork right in front of a little girl.
I did what I had to.
You let a boy get yanked out of a window and into the night so you could protect a pretty girl with a gun.
You weren't there.
The sweatshirt she's wearing was my boy's. You stole that from us.
We were starving. It was cold.
So my family starved in the cold!
How could you know all this?
You're a monster. You're a murderer and a thief. And I'm gonna hurt you so bad.
It doesn't have to be this way.
You can't take care of anyone. After I heard Clementine on the radio and realized who you folks were, I came after you purely for revenge. But the more I heard about the things you did and the danger she was in, our plan changed. Lee, listen to me. I need you to hear this before what happens next. I can take care of her. We can have a family. I bet you don't even know how old she is.
She's 8.
Wrong. She's 9.
But...
her birthday was 6 days ago. I know how to be a dad, you know. She wouldn't be exposed to what she has been with you.
That's not happening. You're crazy.
Keeping her with you is crazy.
Let us go.
No. No, I don't think so. You're going away, and we're starting a new family. Hey, honey. I think this is all gonna work out.
What are you...
I'm glad to. I wish it wouldn't have had to get this bad, but it's all over, hon. Isn't it?
Just about.
I hate seeing you like this. I just miss your smile, honey. I miss you so much, Tess. You're gonna like Clementine a lot, though. She's not Lizzie, but she's sweet. She wouldn't hurt a fly.
Somewhere safe.
You don't smell good.
Yeah, I know. Let's get out of here, okay?
Yes, please.
We need to get you somewhere safe. And then we have to talk, okay?
Yeah.
Everything's okay now. We need to figure out how to get out of Savannah as fast as we can.
Too.
Which way out?
Through there. Stuff.
I had to get through a bunch of them to get here. That's how we'll get out of Savannah. You might want to pinch your nose.
Are you done?
A little more. I want to be sure. Just a little more.
So gross.
There. That should do it.
I hope so.
And you're missing something.
I thought it was gone.
I thought you were gone.
Thank you.
Stay right next to me. Walk very slowly. Don't look around. And don't panic.
Mm-hmm.
I'll keep you safe.